Hello, just wanted to do an unboxing on this Philips Hue lights. This is the E27 and the GU10. This is a kit that comes with three light bulbs and one of the bridges. So anyway, let's take a closer look. Let's take a closer look at this GU10. E27. First, these are the 2017 models without the remote control. They were on sale in my local warehouse, so I got a pretty good deal on this. I bought three of these and three of the GU10s to replace my home light. At least that's the plan. But let's take a closer look. This is the front of the box. Limitless possibilities. It sounds nice. Left side of the box here. The back. There's some details. You can see 806 lumens. 10 watt. So they are pretty bright. And three times. You can see three light bulbs and a Hue bridge. I think it's the latest one. Oh, this is the left side. The other was the right side, but you can see here supports Apple HomeKit, Nest, SmartThings. On the 2018 box, it says it supports Alexa and Google Home as well. They do. This one support this also, but it's not on the box. The bottom side of the box here. A plus. So they're great for to save some money on the power. And of course the Philips logo here at the top of the case. Let's just cut through this right here. And take a closer look at what's in the box. Take this one over here. Open it up like so. Of course, you here, personal wireless lighting. And this is the way it comes in the box. Three light bulbs and the bridge here. Let's take out the bridge first. I don't know if you can see this, but it says Philips in the middle here. It's also a button. There's some logos there. It does require 5 volt, 1 amp. I hope it's USB. Of course it's not USB. I have to plug it in as well. But this one goes to your router. And of course, all kinds of writing in the bottom of this. So this is the bridge itself. This is mandatory for it to communicate with your phone. It supports Apple HomeKit as well, which is nice, which is one of the reasons why I'm thinking about upgrading to Philips Hue, so I can use it with my Apple devices. Right now I have a Yee light, at least multiple places at my home. Even though they are okay, I find them to sometimes make a pitch noise when they're just in white mode. And it's kind of loud. I can listen to it or hear it several meters away. And it's getting a little bit on my nerves. Plus, I don't think the Yee light is well calibrated. There is some slight variations between them, at least what I can see. And the Yee light does not come in GU10 or E14 either, so that's one of the reasons also I wanted to go with Philips. Anyways, this is the bridge. The power adapter. I don't understand why they just couldn't make this a standard micro USB or USB Type-C, so I could just connect this to my router's USB port and don't have to connect yet another thing to drain a battery. I mean the power on my outlet. Anyway, you can see here the writings on the, if you can see, but there is a lot of writing here on the one side, and of course here's where they put the plug. And I suppose the plug is included, yeah. This is of course the European plug. Goes in like so. Until it says click. You push it here if you want to take it off again. But this is the way you put it on. Let's put this one over here. It also comes with a LAN cable. Again, great. They included this in the box. And of course, three of these bulbs here. You can see here, 806 lumens, U, white and color. I wanted to go with the color one because you can create some unique lighting at your home. And of course Philips here at the front. U, white and color. Got this kind of unique shape. I don't think I have to take them all out, but you can see here they are all the same bulb in the box here. Some writings to the left here. Meet Hugh, get started. This is just a get started guide. So what you do is you turn on your light, connect the bridge and download the Hue app. So easy three steps. And this is a, what is this? Something about the HomeKit. I'm not quite sure, but it's in multiple languages. Oh, it's about the warranty and the warnings about the product. And of course, you can see here it supports Apple HomeKit, which is a great plus, a big plus, I think. So that's all that's in the box here for the GU, I mean for the E27, the big the biggest light bulb they make, and of course this Ethernet cable. Now let's go check out the GU10. This one here, of course the box is pretty much identical. It comes with the same stuff, three light bulbs and the U bridge, but let's check it out anyway. The front here of the box, right side, the back side of the box here, and this one is only 250 lumens, so I was not quite sure it was enough for me. It's supposed to replace my current one, which is also LED, but they are much brighter than this, so I'm kind of interesting to see if they can provide sufficient light for me at least. Left side here again, this is the 2017 version. In the 2018 version there's also Amazon Alexa and Google Home logos here on the left side, as well as it comes with the remote control that this one does not come with. But okay, again, this one was on sale, so I could not resist. Let's cut this one open. Of course, you can have a look at the bottom here. This one is only A, not A plus like the other one. So strangely, they are not as bright, and at the same time, they use more power. So I don't know how those two combine. But let's open this up. Cut through this ribbon here. Put it over here. Hue personal wireless lighting. Surprise, surprise. And again inside here, you can see the bridge, the latest one, which is HomeKit enabled. You can see the HomeKit logo here. Of course, you can mount this to a wall as well, so it's great. LAN cable, power cable here. Let's put this over here. same LAN cable here included. It's just a cheap one, but it's sufficient. Same power plug here, and of course the same adapter as well for the European version. And the light bulbs here themselves, oh, they're actually quite heavy. I didn't expect that. It's made of metal. I was expecting it to be plastic, at least in the photos you can see here. They look very plasticky to my eyes, but in fact they are quite heavy, heavier I think than the E27 ones, and made all of metal. Of course you can see the Philips branding here, Philips Hue White and Color, and all kind of writing here on the bottom side here. It's 6.5 watt, 250 lumens. And quite interesting to see how well these will stack up against my current spotlight, LED spotlight. So yeah, this is what you get, three light bulbs in the startup kit here. The U-Bridge, I think this is version 3 or 2, I'm not quite sure, but it's the latest one. LAN cable, power adapter. So the box contains the same things, just different light bulb types. So anyway, I hope you find this somewhat useful. Thank you very much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.